What happened at a wedding that made it obvious that the bride and groom shouldn't be getting married? Are they still together? My sister-in-law got married last fall, and after the ceremony they got in an epic fight over the marriage certificate and didn't come to the reception until 2 hours after it started. A week later, they separated for a few weeks while trashing each other on Facebook. They're still together and she's now pregnant. Edit. I also photographed this wedding and it was the most stressful professional experience I've ever had. I forgot to mention too that the groom and groomsmen dropped a bunch of acid before the ceremony and continued into the reception. He freaked out, had a panic attack, and left. Dropping acid before your own wedding is a bold move. They got married after a 10-year relationship. The wedding was painful to watch as they had such a bad fight the night before. They barely spoke to each other all day, hardly looked at each other. They split up 8 weeks later. I know three couples who were together for over 10 years before getting married and none of them worked out. You'd think they'd have a good foundation in the relationship, but I guess getting married sets different expectations and by that point, no one wants to change anymore. Maybe after such a long time the reason to get married might also be an attempt to save an already failing relationship. On their first dance, he kept trying to kiss her and she would avoid it very subtly. I noticed that and thought, I don't think she loves him. I wasn't wrong, they divorced within the first year. I saw a video of the first dance like this, my brother-in-law taped it and said this couple is getting divorced. Not even 3 months later they were divorced. My good friend was marrying this guy. We will call him Ned. Ned definitely had a drinking problem that everyone swept under the rug. He promised my friend he would keep it under wraps for the wedding. He made it down the aisle, but by the reception he was binge drinking. By then end of the night the groom Ned completely disappeared. No one could find him. A few nervous laughs turned into mild panic when the lights were turned on in an effort to find him. My husband decided to go look for him in the parking lot where he finds Ned on his lips in the dirt. He had smoked a joint and got the spins. My husband tried to talk sense into him, reminding him, "This is your wedding, dude." He got Ned to come inside and did the most cringy walk of shame past the bride's family, who was very cross with him. Ned was supposed to drive them 11 miles from the venue to their hotel in bride's grandfather's vintage Corvette. He was too drunk to drive, so the bride's grandfather drove them and the bride had to sit on the middle armrest with no seat belts. Grandpa drops them at the hotel. Bride barely gets groom up to the room where he passes out on the bed. Bride had to wander the halls looking for someone to help her out of her wedding dress since her groom was passed out drunk. The word annulment was definitely floating around that next morning. As crushed as the bride was, she stuck it out. 3 years later they are now separated and divorcing because he is still a drunk. At a friend's wedding 2 years ago, the bride kept the bar open until 3 a.m. after the groom went home at 10 p.m. She kept telling everyone that she is just with him because he has money and a flat. They are now going through a divorce after she cheated on him. We were good friends with a couple who fought all the time. She wanted to get married desperately and he was indifferent. After years of nagging, he finally proposed. On the day of the wedding, right before he walked out, he looked at us and sighed, "Well, maybe now she will stop nagging at me and finally be f happy." They are now divorced. She cheated on him with some guy she used to date. The bride got so drunk that the bar cut her and everyone else off. The groom was also drunk. People started leaving at midnight, and the bride got mad and yelled about how they were all ruining her wedding because she wanted to dance and drink more. I was their designated driver to get them to their hotel. The entire drive there, they fought. She berated him. He cried. That was a long 20-minute drive. I could have scrubbed vomit out with cleaners, but the awkwardness has stained that car forever. They've been together 7 years. Their daughter, born 9 months after the wedding, is adorable. During the cake cutting, he smashed cake in her face. She immediately started crying and went to the bathroom for about 30 minutes. Then they got into a huge fight and barely spoke the rest of the night. Shockingly, they are still married, but they still fight all the time. She's my friend from college, so we keep in touch occasionally. She never has good things to say about him. My mama has always said it's pretty telling how a couple behaves during the cut of the cake. I've always paid attention to that, and she is right. The level of respect they have for each other shows up better at this moment than any other. I've noticed this, too, especially if I've heard rumor of difficulties leading up to the wedding. Couples that I heard fought a lot seem to have aggression during the cake cutting. It's not always smushing equals fighting, but whether someone seems to be using it as an opportunity to embarrass the other person or whether they're having fun. Bride got drunk and started screaming about how much she hated her in-laws, who were obviously within earshot. They lasted a few years, had kids, and unfortunately are spending thousands in a nasty divorce right now. About an hour before my cousin's wedding, she made the comment that her next wedding wasn't going to be as big and complicated. She was right, her second wedding was super small. Edit, totally forgot the possessive s, oops. Holy. I came here to post something similar. I was a bridesmaid in a wedding where the bride was planning her next wedding in the car on the way to the wedding. Everyone was completely silent before her maid of honor said, "Let's just get through this one." Edited to update, the couple lasted 3 years. That entire scenario, especially the maid of honor's brush off, could be a beautifully hilarious scene in an awesome dark comedy. While getting up the stairs, the groom stepped on the bride's gown, she turned and slapped him and called him blind. He turned the other way and left. Oof, good for him. My brother's wedding. It was super uncomfortable and awkward during their engagement. My parents kept asking him if he was sure, he said yes. Then came the wedding. Super small. When they said to kiss, they both went in for a peck, but she turned her face at the last minute, so he kissed her cheek. My husband yelled for them to do it again. I was also their wedding photographer and he knew I didn't get a good shot. The marriage only got weirder and worse from there. They acted like they were on an awkward first date every day. Finally, a year later, they divorced. Did they not even like one another at all? Turns out, no, part of me think they both wanted to get married to someone, just not each other. The bride and groom both got coked up and got into some kind of argument over the bride wanting him to help her undo her dress. It ended with the groom beating the bride beyond recognition and being arrested. He was charged and given a restraining order, and their marriage lasted one day. See, I'm always curious about this. Would this outright annul the marriage? I'd think so, but I don't know a lot about marriage law. A wedding guest looking out of the window beamed at the groom waiting at the altar and said, "She's here," and the groom jokingly pretended to run away. It went down like a lead balloon because he had actually run away the previous year, literally went out to the shops and didn't come back for 8 weeks, while she was pregnant with their first child. The bride's mother gave him a look that would have wilted the wedding flowers, and happy chatter in the room turned to frosty silence, just in time for the entrance of the bride. They are still together many years later and have had more children together, but I wouldn't describe them as happily married. The way you described the bride's mother's face was fantastic, laughing out loud. The bride was constantly on her phone and very often had to go to the bathroom with it, like a lot. She did this a lot the year of the wedding, and on the day of, and something didn't seem right. So someone followed her, she went into one of those family bathrooms that only had one toilet in it, and she forgot to lock the door. One of the bridesmaids opens the door and the bride is spread eagle finger blasting herself on FaceTime with an ex-boyfriend. Wedding obviously was stopped at this point, groom was furious. Turns out she had been cheating on the groom pretty much the entire time they had ever been together. Holy, I wasn't expecting this to blow up so much. To answer some questions, no, they didn't get married. I have no idea if her and the bridesmaid are still friends. As far as I know, the bride moved on to the next victim. I ran into the groom maybe 4 months after this all happened. He said when he left the reception, he went and packed a suitcase, and flew to Jamaica for like 2 weeks, quit his job, changed his phone number, and when he came back, she was gone. Doesn't know where she is and doesn't care. He sold his house and bought a piece of property and built a small house on it, like 700 square feet. I don't remember what he does for a living now. but he made it clear he will never trust another woman again. Haven't seen him since then.